touch the tenement windows. They were largely black families. And I related to it somehow. My bumper sticker reads, "Just another version of you." And that is my belief. We are just versions of each other.
214, take 3 mark.
There weren't any African Americans on TV at that time to speak of, with the exception of, Amos and Andy. If I wanted to see someone that looked like me on the screen, it was usually Sidney Poitier in the movies. That was about it.
James, honey, what happened? Did you graduate?
Has the pig got knuckles?
James, it's beautiful.
You are now looking at a skilled laborer. No more busting my back on the loading dock at Brady's. This means good pay, good jobs, and goodbye, 79-cent muscatel, and hello, $1.50 champagne.
The vibe couldn't have been better going into the show. Everybody was enjoying themselves. Everybody was having a great time. Then something changed with the adult players, because a sense of responsibility to their audience, to their race, descended on them.
Esther, at the in the first act, you're the one who says to Thelma, what's the matter with, if you don't have the same interest, honey, there's something wrong. I mean, in effect, that's what you're saying. You recognize that they don't have the same interest.
It's not necessary.
I'm saying that it's not necessary to have the same interest.
And she cites the relationship with
I don't follow it. She's upset with that she doesn't have the same interest. So you say, okay.
There are lines that were dropped on you that were meant for you to say because you were black. And I had to see behind all of that foolishness and say, no, I can't say that.
But yet, some of the things I was saying in the beginning.
Yeah, but to do that is to ignore completely what's happening.
Right.
Esther and I both had assumed the responsibility of being the first black family on TV. And I was worried about what people would think. I didn't want to be seen in a role that was going to disparage and denigrate a black family. I wasn't going to do it. I wanted it to be right.
She's the fuse that sets off Kid Dynamite!
Once he said dynamite, there would be a space of maybe half a page, 10, 15, 20 seconds, which can be an eternity in television, where the writers wouldn't have to write. Just let him say dynamite, we can coast for a while.
I don't know about Kid Dynamite!
It grates on my nerves, I couldn't stand it. To make him the most popular black in America, or in these United States, was a way of putting us all down.
Greetings from the chicken shack!
I insist that you can have comedy without buffoonery.
So everybody's used to that, right? Okay.
John Ania has another precept, but he'll be in tomorrow. So we have guys from standing. What's his name?
We had to do the show for 26 weeks, and it had to be good. But we couldn't deal with this reaction of actors being upset with the script all the time. It was extraneous to the needs of a show that had to be done every week.
Thelma, where's Thelma?
And so I sat everybody down and said, these are decisions I'm going to have to make. I'm not black, but I am a father, I am an uncle, I am a brother, I'm a son, I'm all of those male things that John is, and I don't think there's any difference. You guys know the language, the behavior, but we share the same feelings.
He said, John, don't take this quite so seriously. He said, you've got a wonderful role. enjoy it. But I was taking it extremely personally, to the point that the writers got tired of their lives being threatened over jokes and scripts and punchlines. My thing was take the crap out or let's fight.